Welcome to ePaathshala lecture series on postgraduate courses. We are discussing on cryptography network security. Now we are going to continue with advanced encryption standard part 2. To know details of Reindl, that is AES cipher, already we have discussed in the previous part where we understood what is a substitution cipher. Now we are going to continue with that particular other operations. And also we are going to discuss about the steps in each round and the key expansion, how the key is going to be expanded, and finally we are going to discuss about the understanding of implementation aspect. Shift row, where that is a second stage of our round process. We already know there are 10 rounds. In the 10 rounds, each round will have some component, that is substitution byte, shift row, mix column, add round key. So already we have discussed about substitution byte. The next operation is shift row, shifting which permits the bytes. Shifting means which permits the bytes. For example, the color which can able to easily understand how the shifting process is going to be happening. For example, when you take the first row, because it is going to be a row wise shifting, it is taking the first row. And also it is a circular byte shifting, there is no loss of data during each and every shift operation. We will take the first row is unchanged, that means you can able to see the color, there is no change in the case of first row, whereas in the case of second row there will be one byte circular shift to left, that means the red is shifted to left, that is each and every byte is shifted to left, that is blue going to the green place, green come to the yellow place go to the red place, and red is again going back to the blue place. That is what the shift operation. And the third round similarly do for that 2-byte shifting. Now already in the first round there is no shift, second round there is a 1-byte shift, third round there will be 2-byte shift, and fourth round there will be 3-byte shift. So as we can able to see that when I am giving the input, here there is no mathematical operation, just simply shifting of the particular byte. In the encryption, the transformation is called shift row. In the decryption, the transformation is called inverse shift row and shifting to the right. That is, here it is left, during the decryption process it is a right, then only it can able to get back the original message. So now as we know, this is obtained from the previous operation called substitution byte. Here we are considering the state, a new state which is arrive after the substitution byte, it is entering into the shift row, the same diagram, but it is this earlier color diagram block is mentioned in the case of your bytes of value. Now I am taking the S0, S1, S0, 2, 0, 3, okay, we are not going to shift anything as it is going to be getting the output, whereas this case you can able to see that how it is going to be shifting and getting back the new state. So each and every time here 1 byte, here 2 byte, here 3 byte, that like that we are going to get that. So 3, 3, 3, 0, 3, 1, 3, 2, this is what happening in the case of your last row of your state. So here with an example how the values are going to be shifted, 63C9FE30, as it is going to be same in the case of your output state also, but in the case of your second row F2 is coming to the first position, then C9 and C9 is coming to the first in the second position from the right hand side. Similarly FA63 and 83, D4 is coming to the last position. This is what happening with the respective shift row, and also it is inverse, the operation is inverse. Here first byte is no right shift, second byte is, second row is 1 right shift, 2 right shift, 3 right shift, get back the original state. After the shift row, the next operation or the next stage is going to be your mix column. Shift row and mix column provides diffusion to the cipher. So as mentioned in the case of your basis of modern cryptography, confusion and diffusion. Confusion in the case of AES, it is given by the substitution byte, but the diffusion part is taken care by the shift row and mix column provided the diffusion. Shift row and mix column will provide the diffusion. Each column is processed separately, here in this particular component where we are going to do a matrix multiplication. Earlier two stages there is no mathematical operation, simple swapping and substitution were happening, but this case some mathematical operations are going to be happening with respect to finite field. We say that is a gf of 2 power 8. So gf of 2 power 8 with respect to your irreducible polynomial x power 8 plus x 4 plus x cube plus x 1 plus 1, which irreducible polynomial, it uses a prime polynomial or irreducible polynomial to perform the matrix multiplication. So now this operation is column wise, earlier is row wise, now it is taking the column wise operation. How this column wise operation is going to be happening is, already I will have some constant matrix. That constant matrix is derived, and now our state value is taken as taking a column of old matrix. From the old matrix, it is able to generate the new matrix. This is with respect to A into X. We cannot say that is a multiplication, it is a Galois field of 2 power 8 operation. A dot X, this dot is finite field operation. So how it is happening with respect to the state, this is what we obtained from the substitution byte. Now already I have some constant matrix, so what I am doing here is, I will take first column, I will do the matrix multiplication. This matrix multiplication is not the matrix multiplication as what see in the normal, it is going to be a Galois field of 2 power 8, gf of 2 power 8. So this value is multiplied and it generates a new value that becomes the new column, that is s dash of 0 comma 0. Similarly, you take the second column and you do a matrix multiplication and generate a new column, new second column, and also it is taking the third column where it is going to do a matrix multiplication to give the third column. Similarly, the process is repeated until you get the new state of this particular operation. So here we can able to see that this is the constant matrix during the encryption process, this is the constant matrix used in the decryption process. This is used to multiply with the state during the encryption, this is used to multiply during the decryption. That is why it is mentioned the mixed column and inverse mixed column. This is the mixed column and this is the inverse mixed column. The last stage of our round is add round key. This is a simple XOR operation where XOR state with 128 bit of the round key. The add round key proceed one column at a time. So I will take a key, this is our round key which is obtained with the key expansion process. So how the XOR operation is going to be happening with respect to the state is, each and every time I will take this particular column. If I am considering ith word, I plus first word, I plus second word, I plus third word, then ith word will be XORed with first column. Then ith plus one word is going to be XORed with second column. I plus two is XORed with third column, and I plus 3 is XORed with fourth column, then I am going to get the new column. So that is what is mentioned here, add round key proceed one column at a time, adds a round key with word with each state of column matrix. Again here we can able to see, here is a matrix addition. So before this particular process, I need to generate the key. Once the key is generated, then only I can able to add it with the state. How this output we got, it is from the previous round, the mixed column round. Now I will get the output of one particular round. This is, if you assume that is the first round, then the state what we are looking right now is the output of first round. Similarly, the process is going to be repeated. first it go for the S box, that is substitution byte, next it go for the shift row, next it go for the mix column, and finally it go for the add row. So like that it, this process is going to be happening for, so like that is going to be happening for n rounds. So we can able to see that overall rounds which is going to be displayed in the particular thing, where it take a state, the state is going for substitution byte, after that state is new state is arrived, and we are going for shifting them, after shifting them it go for the it will give the new state, this new state is again go for the mix column, then this is going for generating a new state, and finally we are adding the round key of each and every state. So this is what happening with side the round. Now we have understand the encryption, and also we understand what are the rounds, we know in each round what are the processes are happening, and also we have discussed about the key used in the case of your add round key state, okay, inside the round, add round key scheme in the inside the state. So here this part is explaining about key scheduling, how the keys are generated for the encryption process. So as earlier we know, suppose a user want to share something with the other user, if you're taking two users, they want to share some information confidentially, they have to decide on the algorithm which one they are going to use. Suppose I'm going to take a symmetric key cryptography, then we assume that it's going to be 128 bit, it's going to have only one key for encryption and also for the decryption, they use one single key for both the encryption and decryption. In this we have discussed about 64 bit key which is shared between the two users before starting their actual data transmission. Now in the case of your AES, we know very well there are three different versions, AES 128, AES 192, AES 256. We are going to consider one example with respect to AES 128, how this 128 bit keys are and how it is going to be expanded into an array of 44 32 bit words. So that is why the process is called key scheduling or key expansion. So the key 128 bit key is going to be expanded into an array of 44 32 bit words. So I'll have 44 of each 32 bit words. So now I take this 1 2 3 4, this is going to be one word, each of this is going to be 32 bit, because this 8 into 4 32, like that depends upon the n round. If I'm taking n is equal to 128, then it's going to be have a 44 as the. So how this key is going to be expanded? The key is 128 bit. This 128 bit is represented by K0, K1, K2, K3, like that is going to be 16 part. Each is 1 byte, right? Then we are going to consider 4 bytes as one word. This is word 0, this is word 1, and this is word 2 and word 3. So initially a user shares the secret key with other user, but this key is entering into the key expansion process. This key expansion process where it is going to be converting this into a 44 32 bit word. So first it is going to take a W0, W1, W2, W3, and then based on this value, it is going to be generating new word for the next round, W4, W5, W6, W7. And similarly, as you look into the other round, that is for the next round, if you take a round 1, round 2, round 3, then we can able to see that it is going to have a W8. This W8 is based on the previous word. that means W4. And finally, we are generating the W40, 41, 42, 43, that means 44 word of 32 bit. So, this is used in the case of your 10th round. Suppose I am taking 128 bit key, this will be used as a last round key. So, how it is generating? For example, W4, how it is generating from W0? So, we have one constant, we say T4, this T4 is generated, sorry, T4 is the constant, round constant, which is taken from the table or a predefined value. Sorry, this T4 is generated based on I minus 1 word, rotate word, substitute word and a round constant of I divided by 4. This block is explaining about how a new word is generated. Okay, this block is generating about how a new word is generated. For example, I want to generate W4 from W0. For example, if I am taking W4, I want to generate W4. What I need is, I need two value. One is T4, another one is W0. So, how the T4 is generated? For example, I take T4 here. I is equal to 4, T4, I want to generate T4, then round constant of I divided by, that is 4 divided by 4, round constant of 1, I need to take it from the table. This value already, it is available. Then I need to go for referring the previous word W0, because it is taking I minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, 3. Then is going for rotate word and substitution byte, rotate word and the substitution byte. So, I will take W3 here, I will take W3, I will apply the rotate word, then substitution byte, similar to that of what we had in the case of your encryption process, and then I am adding the round constant, then I will get T4. This T4 and W0 will generate a new W4, that is all. This process is going to be repeated for all the first word of the round key, and later on this will be XORed with the previous W1 in the case of, if I want to find 5 W, okay, previous word. So, key expansion submodule will take care of rotate word, that is similar to that of your shift row, 1 byte circular left shift on a word. For example, rotate word of B0, B1, B2, B3, it is going to be rotating them to the left 1 byte, that means B1, B2, B3, B3 and B0. Then it is also performing the substitution of each byte of input word using S box, as we seen in the encryption process. After that, it is going for sub word, rotate word, temp in the XORed with the round constant, it is going to be given in the table. So, the round constant is a word in which the 3 rightmost bits are, R constant is a word in which 3 rightmost bytes are 0, 3 rightmost bytes are 0, 1, 2, 3, rightmost bytes are 0, 1, 2, 3, rightmost bytes are 0, it is deferred each round as defined R round constant of j is equal to r constant of j comma 0 comma 0, where round constant of 1 is 1, r round constant of j is equal to 2 into round constant of j minus 1. So, it is generated from the previous value. So, it is able to understand here, this value is used here for generating the T4. So, T4 is generated based on W3 and also rotate and substitution and also round constant. So, like that this key is going to be generated and it is going to be added during the encryption process. Here is an example where it is given with respect to first round. This key W0 rotate word substitution byte, round constant is added T4, and new word is going to be generated. How this fourth word is going to be generated, fifth word is going to be generated, that way you can able to understand. So, AES was designed after this. Most of the known attacks were already tested with the AES, like brute force, statistical attacks, differential linear attacks. So, there are no linear differential attacks are happening with respect to AES till date. So, that is why still most of the application where we can able to see that during the encryption process, they use the advanced encryption standard instead of this. This demo will make you to understand more clearly how the AES is working with respect to the animation. Okay, this animation was made for CryptTool, which is a tool which can help to learn the cryptographic algorithms, various cryptographic algorithms. So, from this we are going to understand how this Reindahl cipher is going to be working. We know very well Reindahl cipher is the AES selection algorithm which can able to generate 128 bit data block and 128 bit key into a ciphertext. With this we are going to start with an animation. Now, as we know that modern cryptography takes plain text is the zeros and ones, and the cipher key, this is going to be again a binary digits, and both are going to be done by the Reindahl encryptor, and finally what is going to be get is the output. This is what the overall process which is happening in your AES. Now, we are going to see what is there inside this particular block. So, this input where we have discussed how to get the block of input and how to arrange them in the form of state. We already did this in the last lecture on AES, where we can able to understand this entire block is 128 bit data, this how it is going to be converted in the ciphertext. So, each is an hexadecimal number where it corresponds to 4 bit of each, 4 bit of binary. So, encryption process. So, this is the overall encryption process I think we already discussed. Now, the state what we have as an input block, it is taken into the first and addition to the add round key, later on to the number of rounds. Depends upon the key size, the number of rounds is going to be determined. Now, the current position is 0, when the process is started, for example, if you are going to take 128 bit key, this is going to be happening for 10 rounds, and finally, the output is going to be given as a ciphertext. This is the last round where you can able to see that the all the n minus 1 rounds will have 4 stages, whereas in the last round, we are not going to get the mixed column round. So, now we can able to see how the inputs are taken and it is going to be processed. So, round 1, round 2, round 3, like that it go for 9 rounds, and then during the 10th round it go for the last round. So, this process is what happening in the. Now, we will see there are 4 types of transformation. One is substitution cipher, shift row, mixed column and add round key. We will see how each and every process is going to be happening with the help of this step. So, the first one is substitution byte, where already we know each and every byte in a particular block is going to be taking the row value and the column value which is given in this particular S box. So, now we can able to see that now I am taking the first value. The first value is showing the in the first value 1 is showing the row. So, it is looking at the row and 9 is showing the column. So, this is the value what exactly need to be replaced for 19. So, the similarly it is going to be happening for all the other values in the particular state. Now, it is going for the next round called shift row. During the shift row, we can able to see this output is we obtained from the previous round substitution byte. So, now what is going to be happening, it is in the shift row, the first row we are not going to disturb, just it is going to be as it is, whereas the remaining rounds is going to be rotated to the left. So, that is what here it is happening, it is rotating 2 bytes, it is rotating 3 bytes. So, like that it is done in the shift row round, and then it is going to take the mixed column. In the mixed column we know very well already we have some matrix which is the Galois field, which is based on the Galois field, it is going to have some matrix during the encryption process. This is already predefined, where it is value is going to be taken from the, this is our input which we obtained from the shift row. After shifting the row, we got this input. This input one column is taken and it is taking to go for matrix multiplication. This is what we say that dot operation, which is respect to the Galois field. And finally, we are going to get the output of all the columns. Then we have the add round key. This already we have generated with the key generator. So, each and every key is going to be added with the XOR operation, getting the new column wise XOR operation. Finally, you are going to get the, this is what overall process which already we have explained. So, after 9, after we are getting the 10 round, this is what our output of the ciphertext. Now, we can come to understanding of how each and every step is happening inside the AES with the help of this animation. Implementation aspect, algorithm used in AES are easily implemented using cheap processor and minimum amount of memory, not going to take the much higher, very efficient. Implementation was the key factor in the selection of AES. So, we are coming to the conclusion to state that we are detailed discuss about Reindahl algorithm, look up the state of each round, and also we are discuss about key expansion implementation aspects. Thank you.